Hi, I'm Grace Black, and Rebecca Weisman is my partner for this project. We are going to discuss one story told by two different films, the story of Henry VIII, and particularly his relationship with Anne Boleyn. The first film is Anne of the Thousand Days, and the second film is The Other Boleyn Girl. Rebecca really hones in on the introduction in her video, and so I'll let her talk about that. The truth claim of Anne of the Thousand Days, Rebecca also talks about in her video, but I just wanted to touch on that. It is implicit. There was no direct statement or given anything about how this is based on a true story because of how famous the historical events are. Some aspects that were orally effective in Anne of the Thousand Days were that the music is just so awesome. Both background and what the characters hear, like the dancing, really fit the time period, and the background music fit the time period, but also let you feel what you should be feeling. It really meshed well with the events that were happening in the film. Also, the other sound effects that were in the film, like the horse trotting, I thought that was very nice, and the castle creaking and the doors and all of those things really added to the accuracy. If you see something happen, you should be able to hear it too. A big part of oral accuracy was some of the things that you would hear in conversations. They would talk a lot about a religion and how the bishops and the Pope and the Catholic Church was also prominent, and that is just something that was super accurate to that time period. They also talked a lot about marriages and arranged marriages and who would be a good fit for who, and getting up to be at a certain rank was just all really accurate to the time period. However, some of the conversations seemed to not fit the time period, like they were a little unbelievable, just how open everybody was with everything that was going on. It was just a little unbelievable to me that everybody knew everything and everybody was so openly talking about things when everybody usually, when you think of this time period, was reserved and private. So that just kind of rubbed me the wrong way. Also, most of the accents were pretty accurate, especially Anne Boleyn's, but her dad's was not, and it kind of took away some of the scenes for me since her accent was so great and his was not so great at times, so it just kind of made it seem a little unbelievable. Thematic aspects of Anne of the Thousand Days, some of the ones that were just super important to me and effective were that the parents were openly talking about, to their daughter. I feel like that is just time period appropriate. I feel like the parents knew everything about their children. They make like family decisions. Everything's a family decision. So I thought that was appropriate. Also, I think the film did a great job of how initially Anne hates Henry and then she grows to love him and then he does not. I think that that is just a really overarching theme, and I think that the film depicted that super well. The reactions of people also were a very good aspect that was displayed. The crowds booing Anne when she finally became queen and calling her a whore because of how much they loved Catherine really stood out to me, because that is something that I think was very appropriate. Everybody just didn't like her, and so that they voiced their opinion, and as the villagers, I think that that was just super great. I also think that the actor who played Henry, portrayed the internal conflict he was having with providing for his country and what he wanted. I think that that really was a good aspect, that just the way he did it was just phenomenal. You could really feel all of the feelings that he was feeling, and you could see that it was hurting him to make these decisions. And lastly, I think the courtroom scene was just really appropriate thematically. I think that the events that unfolded in there and the way that they went about them were just really appropriate to the thematic aspects of the historicalness. However, some things I found were ineffective was that Rebecca and I both thought that this one was a big one, that Anne telling Henry that she was not a virgin and he was just so willing to accept it was very strange. Her boy that she loved, Percy, he was a little taken aback that she wasn't a virgin and he didn't seem okay with it either. So the fact that Henry was just so willing to accept it was a little off since he's the king and virgins were raped, and it was very unfitting for the time period in our opinion. So now we're going to talk about the other Boleyn girl. The truth claim in this was very interesting because it was both implicit and explicit. They did not just come out and say that it's based on a true story. They implied it by their representations of the characters and the historical relevance of this story. And at the end, they explicitly stated facts of what happened after the film. So like the events didn't just stop after the film, there were more to come. So it was implied that this was a true story from that as well. Some things that were visually effective in this film was the attire and the costumes that the people were wearing. They were all very regal and very elegant and put together, and they also looked time period appropriate, for the most part anyway. And then also the castle was just what you would expect the castle to look like. The bedrooms and the other rooms in the castle, all with their high ceilings and all the things inside of each room, really added to the accuracies of this. And then in this film, unlike Anne of the Thousand Days, the pregnancies were very visible. You could tell when someone was pregnant. You could see their belly and things like that. And I think that's an important aspect. If someone's pregnant, you show that they're pregnant. However, some things that weren't accurate, kind of relating to that, is that no one aged. This film started at a different point in time than the other one, and it seemed as if more time had passed. And no one aged, none of the children really aged, none of the adults really aged. So it was just a little interesting to see that everybody was the exact age they were when the film started. And then one other thing that I noticed was that some of the accessories, like some of the hats that Anne would wear or other people would wear, seemed a little bit too modern for my liking to be in this film. Chronologically, the scenes transitioned really well throughout this entire film. Everything seemed like the storyline flowed really well. It was very well put together in that sense. The length of the film was, I felt, appropriate for the amount of events that had unfolded. I was wondering why everything was focusing on before Anne Boleyn became queen, and then I realized that she was not queen for very long, so I think this film really showed, like, gave you a feel for how she reigned for such a short amount of time. Because that's just, it was a very small part of this film. And also, Mary's pregnancy, I think, was a good aspect of chronological piece, just because they said she was pregnant, she didn't look pregnant for a while, and then she was pregnant, and then she had the belly, and then she was on bed rest, and I think that the amount of time and the representation of that was really accurate. some things that weren't accurate was that the film did take place over a long series period of time. There were lots of time that came over, and it just didn't seem like no one aged. And then also, I thought that it was weird that Henry should have looked older. He was much older, and he had been reigning for 28 years, so he has to be over 28 because he didn't reign when he was born. So just the fact that he didn't look very old kind of threw me off, especially when they said how long he was reigning for. So, in conclusion, we decided that the better film of the two for historical accuracies was Anne of the Thousand Days. Although some of the things were a little off, we just felt that the other Boleyn girl was very theatrical, and they romanticized the relationships, and we thought that that was a little inaccurate for what we believe would have actually happened for that time period. So overall, we thought Anne of the Thousand Days was the film that had the most historical accuracies and relevance of the